Hi, it seems that my country, Scotland, is in competition. We are quite competitive people, but they seem to be in competition to be the most woke country, or most embarrassing country. Whatever, it's the same thing, really, isn't it? Before I get to this, I just want to say thank you to Julian, I don't want to say surnames, for getting me a gift on my Amazon wish list. It's very good and I'm using it right now and it's great. Thank you very much, Julian. Anyway, so this story, there's two stories I want to show you just for comparison, but this has been doing the rounds all day on Twitter, right? God, it's so fucking annoying, I swear to God. But the drag queen story hour in nurseries, right? Now, there's a difference between pantomime dames and drag queens, right? Pantomime dames are usually men, well, they are men, dressed up as women, like the Ugly Stepsisters or Cinderella even, or whatever, anything like that, Sleeping Beauty, all that crap. Whereas drag queens are sexual acts that are performed at gay bars, stag do's, maybe even hen do's, I don't know, but you get them like stag do's and stuff, and it is all fun. I don't have anything against drag acts. If that's what we want to do, go for it. I don't judge people who do it or go to watch it, whatever, that's fine. But it is an adult act. I mean, how can you fucking deny that this is an adult act? So that and pantomime are completely different. There's also the differences that drag queen story hour in school in pantomime is different in the sense that if you go to pantomime and you see men dressed as women, you also see women dressed as men, because Peter Pan's always a woman. You also see the women dressed as men, but it's not sexual. Also, you are choosing to take your kids there. Your kids don't come home one day and went, oh, where the pantomime? What? Didn't know about that. You get told about these things when your kid goes to school. So if your kid gets dragged to a drag queen story hour or whatever, you know, a lot of parents don't like that, and a lot of parents might want to say, I'm taking my kid out, I don't want him to be any part of this, this is just wrong, it's wrong. But of course you can't do that either, because there's a guy in Birmingham, I believe, this was just in the paper this week, Muslim guy, surprisingly enough, a Muslim guy who is being charged with a crime because child neglect or something like that, because he's refusing to send his kid to school because of the school's LGBT agenda, so it's like bake the cake bigot times a thousand. You will force your kids to go through the LGBT indoctrination in primary school. It's, again, you say it's sick, you get called homophobic, but we'll get to that, because the gays have now got a gay card, the blacks have got a race card. If you ever disagree with them in any way at all, in any slight fucking way at all, if you say something like, I didn't really like Black Panther, racist, so now the gays have got one, so if you say, I didn't really like Erasure's latest album, fucking homophobe, it's getting tiring, it's getting really fucking tiring. That's why I just take the label now. If you follow me on Twitter, you'll see me doing this all the time, because they don't know how to handle it. That when they call you a racist, I just say, but I'm a racist. And then they don't have any comeback. They don't know what to do, because that was their weapon. That was their weapon to bash me over the head with. Well, you're just a racist. I'm a racist. Oh, shit. And they've taken their weapon away, and they don't have anything else. They don't have an argument. That's why they called me a racist in the first place. So I just say, well, I'm a racist, or I'm homophobic, or I'm transphobic, or I'm sexist. And they don't have anywhere to go once you do. You should totally embrace the labels. Even if you're not, like me, racist or anything, just take it, take the label. Fuck it, because they're going to call you anyway. They're going to call you anyway. Doesn't matter what you do. If you say, oh, well, I'm not racist, all my friends are black, my wife's black, my kids are black, I donate all the money I get to black charities, I give it all to the NAACP, they're still going to go, you're probably just covering for your extreme racism. So it doesn't matter what you do, they're going to call you anyway, so you might as well embrace it and just say, I'm a racist. So I'm homophobic, whatever. So if Hairi Mhairi, fucking Hairi Mhairi, watches this, video and thinks, oh, he's homophobic. I fucking am. I'm homophobic. I can't stand you cunts. You do my fucking head in. Anyway, so let's get on to the story, right? Let's start with the article from The Sun. What a drag. Parents furious as drag queen flo job. By the way, that's the drag queen's name. And it's a he. Let's stop calling it she, shall we? And that's another thing with the drag queens. The LGBT mob are into this, right? They're invested in defending this. But I've never really seen drag queens as anything to do with the LGBT community, because a lot of drag queens aren't actually gay. It's just an act. So I don't know what it's got to do with them, but whatever. Everything is, I suppose, everything's got to fucking do with them. Flo Job, who shares sexual content online, visits primary one kids at Paisley Primary School. Primary one, which is 4 and 5 years old, just for context. Now, the thing about shares sexual content online, right now, I think that's a bit unfair in the way that, like, he wasn't showing the kids that explicit content. So I don't think it's fair to say, well, hang on a minute, you share explicit content on Twitter, therefore you should never speak to kids. I don't think that's really fair. I just don't like the whole drag queen. Go and tell the kids stories, but why do you need to be dressed up like a drag queen? It's fucking ridiculous. It's fucking ridiculous. But anyway, so I don't think it's fair to say, well, he's got this content, because, you know, some of the shit I put on Twitter, you know, I don't want to be told, well, hang on a minute, he said the fucking Holocaust didn't happen, and now he's talking to kids. Oh, fuck off, I'm not telling the kids that, am I? Fucking hell, so it's not fair to judge him that way, but, and I don't even think this guy should be the one being judged. It should be the people making the rules. You know, who invited a drag queen for primary 1, 4 and 5 year old kids? Who did this? Ugh. Fury has erupted after a drag queen who shares sexualized content on social media visited a Scots primary school and spoke to primary one kids. Flo Job read a story to kids aged 4 up to primary 7, which is where my son is, which is age 11, some or 12, at Glencoats Primary School, Paisley, as she, it's not she, is it? As he visited along with MP Harry Mary Black, right? She's with SNP, surprise, surprise. He has regularly uploaded graphic pictures to Twitter, including simulating a sex act with a dildo and simulating oral sex. Again, he didn't share this with the kids, so let's be fair here, okay? Let's be fair here, he didn't share them with the kids. I mean, Harry Mary was there, and she talked shit on Twitter, and she was there with the kids. Why are you not mentioning that, you know? So, it's not real. Those kids aren't on Twitter, okay? They're not on Twitter seeing his stuff, so let's not go. That's not fair. It's not fair to judge him like that, you know? The drag queen also shared a picture of EastEnders star Ian Beale being throttled by Max Branning with the caption, "I need a daddy like this." Again, he didn't share that with the kids, just to be clear here. He didn't share that with the kids, so there's no need for the outrage. If he shared that with the kids, I would understand. Parents have hit out at the school saying the visit was outrageous and disgusting, and that they were not informed it was happening, and that there is the problem I have with it. The fact that they were not informed about it. Why did you not inform the parents of 4-year-old kids that a man in drag is going to be reading them stories? Why didn't you? I mean, some of the photos that have come out about these drag queens, not this one, but some of them, with the kids lying on top of them and stuff, and there was another one where the guy didn't have any underwear on, and he's sitting with a skirt on, with his legs apart, manspreading. You know, and we can see fucking everything. The kids could see everything. I mean, this is disgusting, man. What are they doing, man? The school and head teacher, Michelle Watson, is anybody surprised that the head teacher's a woman? I mean, the chances are it's got to be a woman, because, well, you know how it works. The school's full of women, but anybody surprised that it's a woman that allowed this to happen? I bet it's a Ms. Were forced to lock down their Twitters after being inundated with complaints. One parent said, "While I don't agree with the abuse being given, my kids go to this school. There was no information fed to parents about this happening. Surely that's a parent's choice." Not in Great Britain, it's not. You will be forced to put your kids through this LGBT drag queen indoctrination. Otherwise, you're a bigot who will go to jail for hate speech. "I'm happy my child is learning about LGBT, but it's overtaking the school now. Something every week." Yes. And that's a tolerant woman. I presume it's a woman. That's a tolerant person who's saying that? That's one of the tolerant ones who's like, hey, I'm fine with my kids learning about LGBT, but it's something every week. Yes, it is. It's something every fucking week. You know, do you know they've invented everything, apparently? So have the blacks. It's unfucking real what they're teaching them in school. I have to see the amount of times I have to correct what my son's learned at school. It's fucking unbelievable. It's unbelievable. I can't afford to have them homeschooled. I can't fucking do it, otherwise I would. I'm not opposed to learning about LGBT, but my 7-year-old doesn't need to know what a drag queen is, and certainly not the one they had in. The head teacher is more concerned about furthering her career than tackling issues that our school has, or issuing that our school has. And there's the drag queen. This is a photo. The drag queen shared the sexually explicit online. Now, again, this isn't... He didn't show this to the kids, right? Just come on now. Flo Job has defended her visit. Why are they calling it her? I would understand if it was a transsexual and they've got to be woke and say the right thing, but a drag queen doesn't have the pronoun problem. It's a guy. It's obviously a fucking guy. What are you doing? Another wrote on social media, their username is Flowjob Queen. I mean, even that. Okay, kids, I'd like you to welcome Flowjob. Did you say blowjob? No, I said Flowjob. It was Flowjob I said. Sounded like blowjob to me, miss. No, it wasn't blowjob. I didn't say that. Don't tell your parents I said that. It was Flowjob. Definitely Flowjob I said. And what if, again, it's a dead easy mistake to make. What if the teacher, you know, misspoke and went, right, kids, I'd like to welcome Blowjob. Fuck, you know, it's a fucking mess. Why are you having somebody called Flowjob in to tell... Because we're competing with Canada to be the most fucking woke country. Canada and Sweden, you know. Top three, Scotland, Canada and Sweden. Fighting it out to be the most woke. You know, we've got a third gender here in Scotland. And Canada's like, well, actually, we've got a prime minister who wears blackface and doesn't get criticised for it because he's on the left. So I think you'll find that we fucking win. And the timeline is full of explicit images of them simulating sexual acts. Of course, they've just done a drag queen story reading to primary school children. The drag queen replied, "Don't bring your negativity to my profile. I am a drag queen, yes, who does adult jokes, but I also do under 18 venues and cater around children." A drag queen that does under 18 venues? I'm sorry. No. What are you doing, man? It's just fucking unreal. On Thursday, the head teacher thanked Flowjob and Black, that's Hairy Mary Black, for helping the school's LGBTQ education drive. Yes, because kids really need to know about that. Maths? English? History? Geography? Are you mental? There's no need for that. I don't need to know anything about that. They need to know whose dick's getting sucked, where the penis is going, and whose vag is getting licked. Fucking ridiculous. Women and children's rights group, forwomen.scot, also hit out. This is they're fighting each other, so it's kind of fun to witness. They locked down their thing. Somebody's blocked. That's not locked, that's blocked. Anyway, there's Hairy Mary there. You know, she's a lesbian, by the way, so she's not going to have kids, so she doesn't give a fuck that the kids are going to grow up not knowing maths and English and, you know, who any decent white person in history was. You know, she doesn't give a fuck, doesn't care, man. They wrote, "Sending abusive messages to school is not okay, but questions about this are legitimate. A male who dresses as a sexualized parody of a woman, goes by the name Flowjob, is hardly a role model for primary age children. Did no one check this?" Oh, they checked it, but they don't give a fuck about your kids, so they allowed it, and they also wanted to be woke. You know, they were panicking. I mean, they've seen Sweden, you know, taking the lead. They're like, fucking hell, look how many muzzies they've got, look how many bombs are going off and stabbings that's happening and women getting raped. They're fucking beating us in the woke Olympics here. So they didn't give a fuck, they're just too concerned about winning these woke Olympics. "While we are pleased Flo is planning to go clean, introducing to a primary school someone who only faced up addiction issues days ago is hardly considered. Adult entertainment is for adults, and actually a number of us would probably enjoy Flo's act, but schools and groups for young people have a responsibility to safeguard those people and consider what is and isn't age appropriate." Remember, that was forwomen.scot, you know, so that's the bunch of feminists. "They are the ones who failed the children and frankly exposed Flo." See, I agree with that. I don't think people should be angry at the drag queen, because it's not like he forced himself into the school and went, right, taking you all hostage and I'm reading to the kids. No, they fucking allowed this shit. Why did they allow this? We understand why children might think drag queens are sparkly and exotic. That's the whole point. That's why they use the rainbow flag in the LGBT community and unicorns. That's the whole point. Because kids like that stuff. We understand why they might think it's sparkly and exotic, but they're hardly the norm. They're almost the norm. Surely it would be more representative of the LGBT community to hear from same-sex parents, boring, ordinary parents. Well, I mean, it would be to show them just like normal, you know. I seen a good comment from a guy who said that if you're trying to teach kids about the gender thing, why don't you get a male nurse and a female engineer, and to talk to the kids, you know. I thought it was a better idea, you know, and probably more interesting as well. Learning about values, including equalities and diversity, has an important role in the school curriculum. Yes, learning about fewer whites and fewer men has an important role in school curriculum. All school visits are arranged and managed with the well-being of pupils first and foremost. Nah, I don't think so. However, it's clear in this case the social media content associated with the speaker's stage persona is not appropriate for the children, and had we been aware of this, the visit would not have been arranged. They're not actually seeing that though. We are sorry for the concern this has caused and are investigating. You're not sorry. One of those sorry you got caught type of things. I was only trying to say she's a wee gobshite too. I don't know, somebody got banned or something. SNP, Scottish National Pedo Enablers, right in among Scottish Wains, and wanting the named person scheme in Scotland to make sure that they can do what they want with kids with no interference. I've already covered the named person scheme. The named person scheme, just to let you know, it's they want to basically control how you raise your kids, and they would have like a local counsellor or something to be like a third parent to your child, and it came with these rules. And by the way, they done away with it because there's so many complaints. Doesn't mean they won't try again, because the SNP want control of your kids, you know. But one of the things was that the kids must be allowed to do certain things, like choose their own wallpaper. That was one that got me, you know. My son's not choosing his own wallpaper. If I'm buying it, he's not choosing it. It's fuck off. When he buys it, he can choose his own fucking wallpaper. But they must be allowed to pick their own wallpaper and stuff. These are the rules they wanted to enforce on parents in Scotland. That's why there was an uproar. I think it's about time we took our country back from the government, that for all intensive... I'll ignore that bit. Okay, I'll try my best, but I'll ignore that and move on. For all intensive purposes, allow free... Oh, for fuck's sake, I'm not even gonna risk that. That's what happens and will continue to happen as long as the LGBT sympathisers and supporters elect their own kind into politics. I have posted twice about this, comparing Miss Black to her boss, but seem to have been deleted twice. So much for free speech, eh? Maybe that only applies to SNP supporters. Pretty much. Get the MP sacked. Well, it definitely does, because I remember I phoned the police over Nicola Sturgeon's comments about time to get rid of Conservatives. Remember that? I mean, because if I went on Twitter right now and says, these fucking Muslims, time to get rid of them, that would be hate speech. Scott Brown's fault. Is it Scott Brown's fault? He's talking about the Celtic captain, man. What the fuck? World has gone to fuck. Weirdos allowed into the kids' classrooms. Liberals have been allowed too much, and now they have warped society. Poor kids growing up, they've got no chance with all the sickles in government and places of authority. SNP at their best. It was probably Derek Mackay looking for new victims. The named person act they were trying to impose on the people. I wonder if Flowjob was one of the named persons. So not many people are supporting this, but let's look at what Harry Mary said on Twitter, right? Look, you just know that the people pretending to be livid that a drag queen read a book in a school in my mentions right now are also the people who run out to buy their kids the latest Grand Theft Auto on release day. Your homophobia is transparent. Gay card played. Do you have anything to beat the gay card? Well, actually, I'm black and gay. I think I beat you here. I've got a race card and a gay card, so I think that trumps your gay card, right? But I mean, look how stupid that is. How is it getting to do with Grand Theft Auto? Leave Grand Theft Auto alone. What the fuck is wrong with you, right? And anyway, nobody buys their kids Grand Theft Auto. You know what I mean? They buy Grand Theft Auto for themselves, and then they let their kids play it. They don't fucking buy it for their kids, are you mental? That's for themselves. A drag act is inherently sexual. You may as well have taken a burlesque act along. I should not have to explain this to you. There is only one reason a drag act called Flo Job would want access to children. Don't conflate this with homophobia or video games. Sick. Let kids be kids means letting them know LGBT people exist. Some kids are LGBT. Some kids have gay family members. It's always appropriate to expose kids to gay people. What? It's never appropriate to deny them that. Let kids be kids. Let them know gay people are normal. You know how stupid that sounds? Let's say this guy is gay, this Flo Job guy is gay, right? How is him going into a school dressed as a stereotypical sexualized woman, right? How is that making kids think gays are normal? Doesn't that have the opposite effect? Fucking, God's sake, man. It's always appropriate to expose kids to gay people. What are you talking about? Fucking lunatic. I bet she's gay in her fucking bio or something. Oh, Jesus. Says feminist, right? Okay. Explanation received. It's disappointing you hold this view. There is no GTA in my house. Oh, you poof. I'm all for gay MPs visiting schools. Less convinced it's necessary for drag queens to do so. I can't see why you couldn't accept that on any level without making assumptions like this about folk. Well, because even the gay people that are against this are homophobic. Grand Theft Auto was made in Scotland in Dundee, that's right. And it's so stupid to bring video games into this. It's so fucking stupid. How presumptuous of you. Can you prove this, or is it merely your biased conjecture? Oh, hey, an SNP politician being biased? Come on now. If I want my library to help children overcome gender stereotypes, I would hope they would invite a male nurse or a female engineer. And that's that comment I was telling you about. Not a man in stereotypical sexualized women's clothes twerking at the children while he reads a book. This. I feel like I shouldn't say they're right, you know, but at the same time, I absolutely agree. Stop sexualizing kids young. It's abuse. All that is, he's saying it's bigotry because they're concerned about the children. I think in this case, they're actually concerned about the children. I don't think they're saying it like, you know, the lunatic climate change people, you know, oh, thinking of the children's future. No, this is literally affecting children. Four-year-old kids, by the way. Four-year-old kids. Your paranoia is both obvious and transparent. And, I mean, most people are annoyed. There's even drag queens that are annoyed. I seen a video from a drag queen earlier, and she was saying, no, sorry, I'm saying she. Oh, I can't believe I said she. He was saying, no, it shouldn't be allowed in your kids. It's a fucking adult act. As a responsible parent, I wouldn't let my child anywhere near any game or film designed for adults, just the same as I wouldn't let them see an adult entertainer, which, if you're not aware, is what drag is. Did the name Flo Job not give it away? That's how stupid these people are. Gay role models, no problem. No problem at all with decent people happen to be gay, you know what I mean? Not a problem with that, but there's Graham Linehan, who is against free speech, so let's not read what he's got to say. I was 6 when I saw a drag queen at the Christmas pantomime. No, I wasn't a drag queen, though. That wasn't a drag queen, that was a pantomime dame. There was nothing sexualized about it. Wasn't telling sexual jokes, nothing like that. Enough of your false comparisons, please. There are just something you never forget, and it was all about embarrassing the straight-laced, straight-faced, miserable mums and dads who couldn't handle the fun. If you see perversion, the thought belongs to you. Wait a minute. So the straight-laced, straight-faced, miserable mums and dads who don't like that kind of stuff deliberately took their kids to a pantomime where that stuff is. Are you retarded? Is that what's wrong with you? Why would, if they were against us, why would they take their kids? They're enjoying the pantomime with their kids. You fucking stupid, man. Anyway, when you see the photos and stuff of the drag queen story hour, you know, the mums are there, you know, they're loving it. They don't have a fucking problem with it. The single mums, they fucking don't have a problem with the drag queen thing. Do you know what they do have a problem with, though? This is in the same week, by the way, right? I think it was actually the same day, but whatever. Same week. This is what the single mothers at the school do have a problem with. A man standing, minding his own business, near a school. A man existing near a school, and you think I'm joking? I'm not joking. Watch this, right? Glasgow Primary School, stranger danger! Warning after man spotted hanging around school gates. Parents at Hillington Primary School raised alarm after the male was seen hanging around near the school premises. Now, I know what you're thinking. He was probably offering the kids sweets. He was probably taking photos of the kids. He was probably saying to the kids, hey, do you want to see the inside of a van? He was probably doing that, right? I mean, he must have been. Why would these parents be concerned about a man being near a school? What I mean, early in the morning, he's near a school. I mean, he couldn't possibly be waiting on someone from work, giving him a lift into work, and it's a good place to meet. No, it couldn't be that. Couldn't possibly be that. It must be a pedo. It's the only explanation. Obviously, he's a pedo because he's a male and he's near a school. What man ever walks near a school or stands near a school? Standing's worse. What man stands near a school who isn't a pedo? Come on now, come on. Here's a question. Do you think if a woman was hanging about the gates, do you think the police would have been called? What do you think? Do you think that's... if there was a woman hanging out the school asking kids if they want to see the inside of a van, the police still wouldn't be called. Police were called to a Glasgow primary school after a matter... Oh, fuck off with that shit. Why would you block? Oh, no, thanks. I don't want that thing. Right. Can we move on now? Can I read the article now, please? Are we done now? Done with all the pop-ups? Right. Thank you. Police were called to a Glasgow primary school after a man was reportedly spotted lurking outside. Makes it sound worse, doesn't it? The word lurking. Parents at Hillington Primary School raised the alarm after the male was seen hanging around near the school premises. Oh, obvious pedo. It is alleged parents became concerned after seeing him several times in 1 week. Oh my god, I mean, as I say, he couldn't possibly be using that as a meeting spot to get picked up for work. You know, which a lot of people do. That couldn't be what was happening here. He's obviously a pedo. That's the only possible reason he would hang around the school. Glasgow City Council said police had been informed and after an investigation confirmed that no criminality had taken place. So, that means they must have approached this guy. Excuse me, sir, I'd like to have a word. Ah, what's up? We noticed that you're standing here. Well, yeah, right. Yes, but it's near a school. Right, and you've got a penis, right? So you must be a pedo then, right? No, I'm waiting on my lift for work. You sure you're not a pedo? I mean, they actually must have approached this guy. And I hope the woman, and we know it was women, right? We know that it was women. Come on now, parents, it says, but we know that it was single mothers. I hope they now apologise to that guy if they see him again. But you know they won't. In fact, they're probably already gossiping about him and calling him a pedo. He'll be known as the local pedo and he's never done anything wrong. It's fucking sickening. Pupils will now receive advice on stranger danger. Why? There was no stranger danger. The guy didn't do anything wrong. The police investigated it. There was no criminality taking place. This was just a guy existing near a school, right? And we know that nothing happened and nothing was wrong and he didn't do anything wrong. No kids were kidnapped and raped. Nothing happened. So... why are they having a talk or receiving advice on stranger danger? First of all, why were they not already having that? And secondly, why are they doing it now when there was no danger? What the fuck is that? It's just insane. It's absolutely insane. A spokesman for Glasgow City Council added, in response to these reports, a letter is being sent to carers, parents, advising them that the school's teachers have reiterated the stranger danger message to pupils and asking that this message be discussed at home and that normal vigilance continues when dropping off and picking up children at school. So see that guy that you falsely accused of being a pedo? Turns out he's not a pedo. He's probably just waiting on his mate from work to pick him up. So he's not actually a danger to kids. So because that guy isn't a danger to kids, we're now going to send you a letter to tell you about stranger danger, and we're going to teach your kids about stranger danger because a man with a penis existed near a school, and we can't have that. We can't have that. Community police officers will be at the school at 3 p.m. today to discuss any further concerns that parents may have. They've now got community police officers to be there at the school even though nothing happened. No crime took place. This is pure evil man hatred. That's what this is, you know. And I don't see Harry Mary sticking up for this guy. I don't see her saying, well, that's disgraceful. The guy's just standing there. What a fucking joke, man. What an absolute joke this is. It's like, this every guy must just be paranoid, man. Like, you know, oh, oh God. God, I've got to walk past that school to get home, but a bit across the road and then cross back over once I'm past the school. God forbid somebody sees me near the school and I have to stop and scratch my leg or something. The next thing you know, I'm standing near a school and therefore I'm a pedo. And what if, honestly, women are fucking horrible, do you know that? Because it was women that did this, and we all know that it was women that did this. They're fucking horrible, man. Fucking guy just stands there, man, doesn't even fucking do anything wrong. But you know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of this fucking story from years ago. This is from some American newspaper, I think. 258. The Learning Centre on Hanson Street reports a man across the way stands at his window for hours watching the centre, making parents nervous. Police ID the subject as a cardboard cutout of Arnold Schwarzenegger. That's what it reminds me of, you know. Again, that'll be mothers. We know that's mothers, right? Making parents nervous, not made mothers nervous, because they hate men, they see men as bad, they see men as evil, you know. So they see a man standing near a school, fucking standing near a school, waiting on anything, who knows. In fact, do you know what, he might not even be waiting on anybody, he might just like standing there, and that's his fucking right. If he likes standing there, leave him alone. But no, he's a man with a penis near a school. And by the way, I live across the road from a school, so I must obviously be a pedo as well. And you can take that out of context if you want, I don't care. But it's a fucking wind-up, isn't it? It's a wind-up, man. Fucking hell, man. Can he fucking talk to women, but it's abuse? Can he walk near a school, you're a pedo? I mean, is there anything that men can do? Anything? Oh, I'll tell you what we can do. We can dress as sexualized versions of fucking women and go and read stories to kids. Thanks very much, SNP. Go fuck yourselves. Anyway, thank you very much for listening. Until next time.